Take a deep breath. What are you breathing? It's oxygen, but it's mostly nitrogen, and the same applies to plants, the soil, and even water. So is nitrogen fertilizer a crazy ingredient to use for agriculture or gardening? Air is 78% nitrogen, about 21% oxygen. So manufacturing nitrogen with what? It's mostly made with natural gas today. What's the consequences of using synthetic nitrogen? Yes, let's be honest, it gives a bump in yield, especially in the early years of use while you still have organic matter in the soil. With time, adding more doesn't give you a corresponding rise in yield. It burns up your organic matter because soil wants to maintain a carbon to nitrogen ratio. It also ends up mining your soil. Why? You're just stealing from future generations instead of regenerating the soil. Unless you use nitrogen fertilizer in smaller, more frequent doses, it leaches into the water or runs off during a rain. It emits nitrous oxide, which is a greenhouse gas 256 times more potent than CO2. If it's so bad, why is nitrogen fertilizer still used? Well, follow the money. I'm getting to the trees that will save you from this fertilizer and from ever having to use nitrogen fertilizer again. What did plants do before the advent of synthetic nitrogen? Organic agriculture doesn't use synthetic nitrogen, and it still produces. Yeah, it uses manure, composts, cover crops, and even some organic sources of nitrogen. Did I discover this? No! It's been well known for field crops and lawns. How did I first hear about this? I discovered it with permaculture, and permaculture really introduced me to the idea of nitrogen fixing plants in the form of trees and shrubs. Yes, I knew about it for perennials. Yes, I knew about it for some annual vegetables, beans, peas, but trees and shrubs, that was the discovery. Now I use the idea of putting trees and shrubs extensively in the permaculture orchard where I haven't had to add fertilizer for the last 15 years since I planted. What trees and shrubs do I use in the permaculture orchard? Stick around, I'll give you my top one coming up. But one of the ones I use the most in the permaculture orchard is honey locust. And not just any honey locust, I use thornless honey locust. Because thorns is a thorny issue. It's no fun dealing with spikes and thorns. So get the thornless one. It's not the best nitrogen fixer, granted. But you know what? It's a great support species and support in more than a way of supporting the trees around in the orchard. It also supports grape and kiwi. So now this tree becomes a fruitful tree, not just fertilizing tree. It also is a tree that fertilizes and produces fruit. That's a plus. Don't underestimate it. One of my favorite nitrogen fixers, or at least potentially, this is a controversy. Does it fix? Does it or doesn't it? Check the comments. I'm sure you'll see the controversy. But this is Eastern Redbud. I say even if you don't get much nitrogen fertilization from this tree, just the beauty of it in flower is worth the 10 days of the year that that happens. But it's another choice. It's another option that you could use with your fruit trees, with your lawn, with your garden. And it's beautiful, get that? I said trees and shrubs. Here's a shrub right now in full bloom, autumn olive. And I know people hate on this plant. It's an invasive, it's taking over, it's... Look, nitrogen fixing trees and shrubs are earth restorers, earth repairs. They're there to bring the soil back up to fertility so that if it was a forested area, and it should be because if you're able to grow trees, it was probably forested at one point, so that the forest that is best suited for that area can grow really well. Too bad you can't smell this, because the smell, the fragrance of nitrogen fixing trees and shrubs is really important for your health, but also to attract a wide variety of pollinators and beneficial insects. A lot of times the flowers can be quite small or quite big, but you can just hear the bumblebees buzzing around in here. These trees, or this shrub, is fast growing. How well does it fix? Look, they're on a scale. Some are way better than others, but you know what? They're all trying to make the site better. I did say fragrance, and boy, this is almost peak bloom. Buffalo berry, another nitrogen fixing shrub, hardy. This is able to grow in the prairies. This is a tough plant. It doesn't grow very large. Maybe you have a small yard, a small garden, and you can't put a tree. Then think of some of the smaller shrubs that will fill this void. Certainly fixes nitrogen, certainly attracts beneficial insects and pollinators. But this one also will give you some fruit. Not great, not as good as autumn olive, and not as good as some of the other ones, but it's really the ability of these plants to replace nitrogen fertilizer that is their strong point. These plants make your soil better. Another nitrogen fixing shrub, carrageenan. This shrub loves a lot heavier soil, more clay. We're in extreme sand and it just has never thrived here. But wherever you are, there is a whole range of trees and shrubs. Look up nitrogen-fixing tree or nitrogen-fixing shrub for your area. We're at the northern end, or the coldest end of what is possible. I would be quite certain that there is a lot more that you could use than what I could use. It's another one. It's a possibility. Not for me. Back to trees. I said shrubs, trees. Here's one, a bit controversial as well. Kentucky coffee tree. Not a fast grower by any stretch. And how good is it at nitrogen fixing? I'm not sure. You know what? I said it's a continuum. I look at how well it's doing, and the better the tree grows, the more it's able to capture sunlight and put the fertility into the soil. This one is so-so. It's a possibility, but certainly not if you're in a hurry. One of the best for its ability to fix nitrogen, well, certainly one of the ones that grow the fastest, at least on our site, is black locust. These were seeded from a little seed, and the seeds are tiny, 13 years ago, and they've become the largest trees in our permaculture orchard. They're a great nitrogen fixer, one of the top, and you know what? They're thorny. That is something to consider. If you've got a smaller property, you really don't want to contend with thorns. So I'd say avoid thorny in preference. You have choice, there are options, and thorny is not a trait that you want to be dealing with when you're pruning or just going through the yard and risk getting impaled, because some of these can be quite large in the thorns. But the growth and the ability to capture some atmospheric nitrogen and replace fertilizer is really quite important. Another controversial, in this case tree, is Russian olive. I know some people in some climates, this becomes weedy. And I like to say, you want to grow an orchard of weeds. Weeds in that you put trees that grow extremely easily. If this is growing really easy in your site, then grow it, because there's nothing better than easy. If all you have to do is keep cutting it down, then you've got material to really improve your soil quicker. Because in the end, that's what these trees and shrubs are trying to do, improve your soil whatever your climate, whatever the water you get, whatever your moisture regime is. So these Russian olive, one of the things I like about all the nitrogen-fixing trees and shrubs is that they flower after my fruit trees are done. What does that do? Boy, in the years when maybe the fruit trees didn't flower as much, or they did, and then the nitrogen-fixing trees and shrubs flower a lot as well. Wow, the bees, the native bees, not honeybees for me. I don't want honeybees. We got too many native bees as is. So the bees get such a great store of pollen and nectar. So these help really increase and extend my flower succession. And just for that, they would be really important and valuable as an addition to the orchard, but they do far more than that. This is a beech here. This is an old beech, and that these trees are growing when a whole bunch of other trees and shrubs just won't grow because it's too poor. They are the first stage in getting this site back into shape after years and years of neglect. Maybe you starting in a tough place, maybe your soil has been neglected. Getting some of these trees and shrubs to work and reverse that degradation is really, really helpful. One tree I don't have that's one of the best nitrogen fixers is alder, and there are alders for pretty well every climate in the temperate climate, and they certainly will grow way farther north or colder from where we are. I just never got any, and try them out. They're really a big shrub, not so much a tree, although the European alder is, but alders, from what I've seen, are some of the very best at improving the soil. If you're not sure how the soil is getting, then dig at the base of your nitrogen-fixing tree or shrub. Check it out every once in a while. See how much it's darkening your soil, improving it. See how the plants around it are growing. No tree, no shrub, pretty weak growth in this area. My second favorite shrub for fixing nitrogen is this gumi. How good it works, not certain, but I say second from the top because it fruits, which is a real bonus when you figure it's nitrogen fixing and it produces fruit. That's a twofer. We have it next to our apple here, but that's part of our trio system. So it is meant to fertilize the fruit trees on either side or the nut shrubs, whatever is in our trios. But the ability to stay smaller, you may say, well, it's in my climate, it grows bigger, and probably does. In our climate, it actually winter kills some years. So it has to regrow from everything that was above the snow to regrow. But you know what? This year it's flowering and it will produce fruit, hopefully, and I'll get to try it. And then it might move to my number one spot. Number one nitrogen fixing shrub is sea berry. Why? Because it produces fruit. It fixes nitrogen. It suckers, so it gives you more plants. Can be a pain if it suckers too much. You need male and female shrubs to produce fruit. And normally from seedling, these can be thorny, but these Russian or Ukrainian cultivars are thornless. Great trait. And these, yes, the fruit is amazing. I did say they fruit. Yeah, and it's great fruit, either eaten fresh or transformed. If you plant these, you'll get fruit. If you plant some of the other nitrogen-fixing trees, especially, or shrubs, and they don't produce fruit, then check out this next video and you'll get fruit.